What is going on, my fellow Jedi and Padawans? Welcome back to another Jedi gaming video. Thank you guys so much for coming back to the channel, and if you guys are new, welcome. In Season of the Wish, the Bombardiers, which is an exotic that I know people have not pulled out of their vault for a hot minute for my hunters, got a little bit of a buff. Dodging leaves behind an explosive that detonates after short delay, damaging the targets around it, creating a secondary effect based on your subclass. So Arc, Blinds targets, Solar, Scorches targets, Void suppresses, Stasis slows, and the Strand severs. With this build, we're going to be using it with the Stasis side of it, because with the artifact this season, we have the crazy ability that Shatter Dive with Glacial Grenade is back, wiping out enemies inside of the Crucible. So get ready to make some of your enemies mad with this beautiful Stasis Hunter build. So starting us off with our armor mods, the exotic, obviously we are using the Bombardiers on this with Parting Gift. Like I talked about, we're using Stasis, so we get the slow effect on target, which this got a little bit of a buff this season, adding more of that Stasis slow to them. Now when we add that to when we dodge and freeze targets, it is the potential to actually fully freeze them depending on how much you can get on them when it is applied. Now for our other mods that we are going to be using, totally up to you for your kinetic targeting as well as your unflinching and the loader. Totally whatever you are using, you will see why. I got a couple different weapon options inside of this build. One is a shotgun hand cannon, the other is a fusion hand cannon, pulling out that broken Telesto that I just love to make this build even more cheesy than it already is with Shatter Dive being back. So just make sure that your targeting mods is what you have on for your primary weapon that you're using, hand cannon, whatever it may be. Dexterity is very good for those shotguns, fusion rifles, etc. Now down here we're going to be using Orbs of Restoration and Absolution just to get back our abilities when we pick up our orbs, as well as Reaper Bomber, so we can create those orbs of power with getting our grenade back even faster, which is why we have 100 mobility as well as 100 discipline, having that Glacier Grenade up all the time. As for my two weapon choices that I have been using with this build, very fun for me, the Rose in the kinetic slot or the conditional finality, both absolute juicers inside of the Crucible. I also got this yesterday, a Tiger Sprite, been testing it out, haven't really got too much into it, but seems like a very interesting option. Inside of this one, we got the Telesto, baby, that has 101 defeats on it, and I forgot to switch it to Crucible, so that is all inside of the Crucible. Ballistic Maps Guardians, and I know that they get super upset about it, especially because we're using Shatter Dive. Now we have Igneous Hammer as well to back up our conditional finality. Yes, this is the old one, but it feels so good. Now for me, I got the Juicer Magooser for the Cataphract GL for Crucible with that auto-loading chain reaction on this thing, having it at 85 blast radius. Now, importantly for this build, season 23, inside of our artifact here in the Queen's Foil Sensor, we have these two beautiful artifact perks in Pillar of Ice as well as Hail the Storm. Shattering encased targets and stasis crystals deal increased damage. Shattering the crystals releases shards of ice that damage and slow targets, so those Glacial Grenades and Shatter Dives are extra juicy this season. Pillar of Ice defeating an encased combatant spawns stasis crystals, so when we do freeze them, we'll get that extra little bit of stasis crystals being spawned. As for the Hunter subclass, we got our Revenant, baby, with Silence and Squall. Using the Marksman dodge for me with Strafe, you could use whatever you want. In the Jump category, we got Withering Blade, and importantly, you need that Glacial Grenade right here so we can use that Shatter damage with our Shatter Dive. We can activate midair to descend and shatter nearby targets. This is what pairs perfectly with our artifact mods and how we have this built out here. We're going to be using that Winter Shroud, so when we dodge, it slows nearby targets, and with those Bombardiers, when that grenade hits them as well, because they won't be able to get away from the slow of our boots already with the dodge, then they have the potential to freeze completely, which we can use our Shatter Dive to make even better. As for our fragments, we got Whisper of Torments. You gain grenade energy each time we take damage, so very good for having our Glacial Grenade up at all times. Whisper of Fissures increases the damage and size of those stasis shards when we destroy a stasis crystal or frozen target, so both of those is going to be able to juice the Glacier Grenade and our Shatter Dive with the artifact, hence why this build is back and better than ever. Shattering a stasis crystal temporarily boosts our grenade recharge rate. Shattering additional crystals increases the duration of this benefit. Again, we just have these built out to have our Glacial Grenade as often as possible. This right here in chains helps us to take reduced damage when we are next to frozen targets or stasis crystals. So when we're coming down on that Shatter Dive, helps us to take a little less damage if we're getting punched at the same time, something like that. But when we come down, we can absolutely annihilate enemies. I know that they don't like it. I've got a couple messages already about using it, but it is back this season. It has been so long. Still not as powerful as the OG Shatter Dive, which it had the explosion radius of the entire map, it felt like, but this right here feels very juicy, especially when you're pairing it with the artifact and the fragments we have here. Those couple weapon options, conditional with Igneous or Rose with Telesto. If you pair it with Telesto, just get ready to get messages, because people will be very, very salty with you. But happy holidays again. Truly appreciate all that support lately. Y'all have been killing it for me. I really, truly appreciate all y'all. One Eye Jedi on all of my socials. Join up on the Discord. All of that is in the description down below. So truly appreciate it again. I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace.